Welcome to our Verasys video series. My name is Rob Snauert. Today I'm going to talk about the IOM100 controller and the hardware for the IOM100 controller. The IOM100 controller is used for bringing in miscellaneous points and doing some simple logic. So it has on the board, it has two binary inputs. It also has two analog inputs and it has four binary outputs. In conjunction with the IOM and the Smart Building Hub, Smart Building Hub has a feature called interlocks, and that interlocks works solely with the IOM100. In addition to interlocks, there's features on the Smart Building Hub called load shed and global shutdown. Load shed and global shutdown require that you have an IOM100 installed, because what a load shed does is it'll take one of the binary inputs, and if it makes, it will initiate load shed across the Verasys system. Load shed being, it will expand the set points of the controllers over a rate of time. You have the ability to say how much they're going to expand and what the rate of time it is. The other is global shutdown. Global shutdown being essentially that all Verasys controllers that control units will shut down when initiated off of a global shutdown. So the IOM100 is mainly used for just simple systems. For an example, we could take an outside air temperature sensor and either bring it off of a controller or hardwire that outside air temperature sensor into the IOM and use it with an interlock to do something as simple as controlling a boiler or enabling a boiler. So for instance, if the outside air temperature drops below 50 degrees, turn on this boiler. If it rises above 50 degrees plus whatever differential, turn off that boiler. We can also use it to sync or to turn on other outputs when a schedule in another device is occupied. So for instance, let's say the rooftop unit or a single zone unit, when that's occupied, I want to turn on an exhaust fan or a toilet exhaust fan. We can do those type of interlocks as well. So the IOM100 is a pretty simplistic controller working with those interlocks. We have a field controller bus. It wires directly on the system bus, does not wire on a zone bus. So that's how the connection is made. There underneath the covers here is where the dip switches are for setting the address. And we can have, you know, as many of these IOMs, you know, we can have up to 100 devices on a system bus. So we could have up to 100 IOMs. Unlikely you're going to have that, but we could. Anyway, that concludes the hardware for the IOM100. Hopefully you'll take a look at some of the other videos we made. Thank you.